The cold light produced by the oxidation of luminol has been a popular demonstration for years. But there are even more dramatic ways than we can display this really interesting experiment. So we're going to be using the ammonia fountain to show off the luminol at its best. What I've got here is a 2 litre round bottom flask that I've dried in an oven and allowed to cool slowly overnight. Beneath this we've got about 2 litres of water, and there's some phenolphthalein in there as well. And I've got a delivery tube set up here so that as the bottom of this tube goes into the phenolphthalein solution, the top of the delivery tube is sort of in the top 2/3 of the round bottom flask. The flask itself has been filled with some ammonia, and it's really important to make sure that the ammonia is totally dry. The way that I've done this is to fill from a boiling tube containing about 10 centimetres cubed of ammonia. You can heat that gently with a hairdryer or a small Bunsen flame, and if you leave that going for about 5 minutes, you can collect the ammonia gas in the round bottom flask through downward displacement of the denser air. If you want to check to see whether or not your flask has been filled, you can moisten some indicator paper, and if you hold it at the edge of the neck, then you should notice that it'll go immediately blue. Okay, so we're ready to go. I've got a 20ml syringe here, and I've got a small piece of tubing on the end to make sure that there's a good fit to the orange tubing that we've got on our delivery tubes to make sure that there's no way that air can get in. I'm going to load this up and put in the delivery tube, and we can see what happens as I inject the water. Inject the syringe, aiming to spray water up into the body of the flask. If it doesn't go first time, withdrawing some liquid and spraying again can help. As the ammonia dissolves in the water, the pressure in the flask drops, drawing up more liquid from below. The phenolphthalein indicator turns pink in the now alkaline solution. Now you'll notice that I've drained the flask because it was quite top heavy, but this alkaline condition that we form up in the top flask is actually really beneficial to our luminol reaction. And instead of drawing up liquid from one flask, we can draw up from two and allow them to react inside the jet. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to get one flask that's going to contain some luminol solution. That's 0.4 grams of luminol and 4 grams of sodium hydroxide pellets made up to a litre. And the other one's going to contain an oxidant. In this case, household bleach works quite well. 100ml of that dissolved up to a litre. Make sure it's the stuff that contains sodium hypochlorite, not hydrogen peroxide. Now we need to do this in the dark, so let's nip downstairs. This modified demonstration works on the same principles as the ammonia fountain. I still have a syringe full of water, about 20 centimetre cubed, but this time the apparatus used for injecting comes with a Y-split here. So these two different tubes will be fed into these two flasks, which have got about half the volume each of the top round bottom flask. As the pressure drops, it should draw up the two luminol solutions, and we should get a glowing fountain effect inside the flask. So I'll connect this up and turn off the lights, and let's see what happens.